Hi, it's me on Monday, the day after Easter Sunday, coming out here for another sunset vlog. It's getting a little chilly, so I'm put on my flannel shirt. Yes, and come over here. Sit down next to the table in the backyard and have a little set here while sunset turns into night. Today is the 17th day of spring. And it is the 24th day of the moon, or it was, since it's now night, or going to be very soon. And this is my fourth attempt to vlog every night under sunset, V-E-N-U-S, Venus. Now, you can see that it is now 16 minutes after 7, and I have a beverage here with me, Mountain Dew. I'm gonna stay away from alcohol tonight. And the sky is just a little cloudy. Just a little cloudy. Airplane making some fresh clouds up there. Yes. And over there is where sunset has gone into the west. It is still light, as you can see. The clouds are lit up, but here on the edge of the city, night is falling. I am feeling well. Today's Monday. Thursday, I had my second shot. And I'm feeling as if I'm not going to have a bad reaction. I had a little soreness on the arm. Briefly, well, 2 days, but it was only sore if I rubbed it. And when I slept on it, it got a little bit sore too, because I was rubbing it, putting weight on it while I slept. But I haven't had any fever or any pain or any swelling. My stepsister and her husband got real tired after their second shot. They had theirs about 2 weeks ago. I had mine just last week. But anyhow, I'm feeling well enough that I'm going to have some work done on the cars. The van that you may remember I bought a couple months ago and then decided not to go traveling in because I wanted to take it to a mechanic and I didn't want to expose myself at the mechanic, so I waited. And meanwhile, the battery died. And the other car, which I drive to the store, I was only going to the store once a week, sometimes every 2 weeks, and I let a couple days go by when the battery was low, and pretty soon it wouldn't start either. That was a week ago. So both my cars now have dead batteries. So tomorrow or the next day, I'm going to have, as soon as I can arrange it, with the AAA, which I'm a member of, I'm going to have them come out and check the battery. And then I'm going to take one car to the mechanic. It needed an oil change already, and I'm going to have that looked at. And then a few days later, I'll take the van in and have it checked out and try to figure out how safe it is for me to go traveling in it. And within 2 weeks, maybe three, before the end of the month, I really is my intention, before the end of April, I'll be out at a friend's place. Actually, he's a friend of my son. He's about 30 years younger than I am, this young man. He's in his 40s. Yeah, I know some of you think 40 is old, but I tell you, it's young. So he's offered to let me camp there for a while, and it's out in the hills back of San Diego, and I'll be out there for maybe 2 months, April and May and June. And then when it starts to get hot, if I feel good about staying in the van, I'm going to move my base of operations down to the coast. And if I feel really good, I'm going to go camp out on the beach in Baja. Because I've been missing the corner of Mexico here where I used to live, you know. I lived in Tijuana for 8 years. Now and then I'd go down to Ensenada and points beyond. And in the summer, if you're close to the ocean, it's not so bad in California. But you get up away, certainly out in the desert, it's horribly hot. But you get up in the hills and it's very warm and sometimes hot. You remember last August, I went to the mountains over there just west of us, in the Santa Ana Mountains. I was up around 5,000 foot. And the heat wave came, and it knocked me it was 100 and something every day, and I got heat exhaustion. Or perhaps it was heat stroke. But I went to the hospital for 2 nights back in August. And then I came to my brother's house here, where I'm in the backyard making my 1, 2, 3. Is this the fourth or the fifth one? I've already lost track. Making my vlog every night under sunset. It's either the fourth or the fifth one. I'm sorry, I'm losing track now. So I've been here for 7 months, and it's been good. I've done a lot of writing, a lot of work on the work I've been writing about ancient people back in the first century AD. About several different characters that I've been working with. And I've been meeting with poetry groups now and then, not all the time, but maybe once a week. And listening to people read poems, and once or twice actually reading one of mine, but I've been getting away from that. I'm more interested in listening to people now. And I'll be keeping that up as long as I can get internet contact, Wi-Fi from different places. My computer can pick up Wi-Fi, and I'll have to be prepared to not have internet. I may actually not be able to upload my vlogs, but once in a while. Whereas now, my brother's got internet here at the house, and I've been using it since August. That's how I uploaded the video about driving to get my new camping van. That was 3 months ago. And every other thing I've uploaded has been here at his house. But they're moving out. It's now that everything's kind of settling, and they've all except for my youngest nephew, his older sister, my niece, and his mom and dad, my brother and sister-in-law, and grandma, my brother's mother-in-law, my sister-in-law's mother, they've all had their shots, except for my nephew, who's going to get his within a couple of weeks, we think. He's pretty young. He's only 22. His sister is 27, but she had a link through her work in Los Angeles that she could get it. It's starting to get a little bit dark, just a little bit. You can see how the darkness of the sky up above, it's darker, and down in the west, it's still shining. That's the twilight. I told you yesterday about the three stages of twilight. We're just now leaving civil twilight and moving forward into navigational, almost in navigational twilight. I can't see the first star. Oh, there it is. I see the first star. So we're now entering navigational twilight. I'll be here for a little while longer talking at you, and because there are a couple of things I wanted to say. Let's see. I'm going to get the cars worked on. Probably next day or two I'll have AAA come out and charge the batteries and tell me how bad the damage is to the battery, if I need new ones or not. And then I'll be taking them both into a local garage here that seems pretty nice. When my mirror fell off of the one car off the windshield last fall, they sent a guy out and he fixed it up for just $10. Anyhow, I'll be getting them looked at, and then I'll have to transfer. That's what I want to remember, was the process of moving everything from here, which is 100 miles north of San Diego, down to San Diego, and then up into the hills outside of San Diego, where I'll be staying for 2 or 3 months until it gets too hot. So after I get the cars worked on and oil changed and all that stuff, I may have to rotate the tires. I hope I don't have to buy new tires. But I'll be taking one down to San Diego. And then, here's the doggy. Hello, Freya. She's a big dog. There she is, you see? She's a standard poodle, like Charlie that traveled with John Steinbeck. You know, travels with Charlie. He had a standard poodle traveling with him. I will not be taking this dog with me, so I won't be having travels with Charlotte. Her name isn't Charlotte, her name is Freya. Hi, girl. Yes. But I'll be taking one car down to San Diego and then riding the train back up here. There's a connection through to Riverside, which is only about 15 miles from my brother's house here, maybe 20 miles. And I'll come up and then get the other car. Now, in the process, Freya. There's my brother calling the dog. Freya, Bruce is calling you. She went to the bedroom door. Yep. There's my brother. He's calling the dog. Anyhow, after I get back up here, I'll take the other car down to San Diego. And then, by then I may actually have arranged to sell one of them. Because I went online with Carvana, you know, they'll come and pick up your car and pay you for it. And I told them all the problems that my old car has. It's a 1999 SUV. It's Lexus. It's made by Toyota. And my stepfather bought it in 2003, 2004. And he bought it so my mom would have a big, heavy car to drive and be safe in. And I went to live with my mom in 2008 and drove her pretty much everywhere because she'd quit driving. Could have sworn I heard the dog breathing heavy over there. Well, anyhow, I may sell that car and only keep the van. Because I could get, you know, $3,000 or $4,000. Carvana offered me $3,000-something on it. And I just might do that. The car's old, but the motor's in good shape. It's only got 94,000 miles on it. And it's sentimental value for me, but I don't need two cars. And I certainly could use the $3,000 to pay for my cheap little lifestyle. I only have $20,000 a year in income. That's my retirement income. It's maybe $2,000 a month, maybe $1,800, $2,000 a month. That's it. And now I've been buying a lot of groceries here, but I'll be paying less for myself when I get away. When I finally leave. But it's nice to have a house to live in, and I don't mind spending extra money on groceries because it's my brother and my nephew. My nephew's in school, he's going to college on the internet. He marches in a band, except there's no band marching nowadays. He's a very intelligent young man. Our family has a lot of people. We're all too smart for our own good. Anyhow, I'll probably be selling one of the cars and keeping the van, selling the 22-year-old SUV and keeping my 12-year-old cargo van. It also only has 90-some thousand miles on it. And it's perfect for camping, driving around and sleeping in campgrounds because I don't have to put up a tent. I can just sleep in the van. Or if I want to, I can put up a tent and sleep outside in the tent. It's much better than the SUV. And I'm pretty much resigned to the fact that I'm not going off-road anywhere. I'm an old guy, and although I can still get around and I can still go camping, car camping, but I shouldn't be going off on beaten roads where there's nobody to check on me if anything happens. So I'll be staying pretty much in regular campgrounds or places nearby regular campgrounds that are free or inexpensive, but have, you know, rangers nearby in case anything happens, because that literally saved my life last summer when I had the attack of heat exhaustion or heat stroke. The reason I'm alive is because a ranger came by and I waved at him and I said, "I feel weird. It's 105 degrees and I'm having chills." That was definitely a problem. But they saved my life. So I won't be going out in the boonies, except places that are near to ranger stations and places where I'll be able to make an emergency call if I have to. I am thinking of going down to the beaches in Baja California in the summer, staying close to the ocean. In Baja California and here on this side of California on the north of the border, staying close to the beaches. And then in September, when it gets a little cooler up in the hills, maybe going back up and into the hills. But we'll see. we'll see what happens. First, I got to get the cars looked at, and then I got to get them down to San Diego and maybe sell one of them, and then get them out to, or get the one that I keep out to the hills to my son's friend's place out in the back country of San Diego County, where he's got a little piece of land out there with a house and some open land and trees. He's even got a fire pit. He built a campground for himself, and he said I could come and use it for a while. Anyhow, it's getting darker now, and I think it's about time for me to show you the star. Yeah, let's see if we can focus. Yeah. It's up there somewhere. Come on. Where are you? I know you're up there. I can see you. Maybe you see it. You see, there's a problem with focus here. It's right up there. I know it's up there. I can see it myself. Come on now. Is that it? There it is. There it is. That is the star Sirius. It is the first star I see tonight. Starlight. Star bright. I wish I may. I wish I might. Oh, first star I see tonight. I wish upon a star. Yes, I do. I'll see y'all tomorrow when I make another, if God is willing, another vlog every night under sunset. Bye.